So Bol Bol has been waived again, this time by the Orlando Magic. So we have seen Bol Bol, I guess this is the first time we've seen him been waived, but we've seen him bounce around after bounce around after bounce around. It feels like nobody wants him. He was originally drafted by the Miami Heat. They didn't want him. They traded him to the Denver Nuggets. The Nuggets hardly ever played him, and when they did, it felt like he scored a point per minute or more. Like he was outscoring his expectations and how many minutes he played felt like pretty good. And a lot of people were like, okay, why does this guy not get more of a chance, more of an opportunity? There was one random game in the NBA bubble where they started him alongside Nikola Jokic and Mason Plumlee, like a complete whatever, let's just throw this lineup out. And I can't remember exactly how it did. But other than that, he really didn't get much of an opportunity whatsoever in Denver. And when he did, like I said, he looked good. So then they traded him to the Detroit Pistons. Well, it turned out he had a broken foot and he needed surgery on it, and he just didn't know. So he failed his physical, obviously. Well, then the Pistons are like, okay, well, you failed your physical. We don't want you. And they sent him back, which is very weird because the trade was just for Rodney Magruder. That's it. It was a Rodney Magruder Bol Bol trade. And they still, even though he had a broken foot, they were like, nah, we'll keep Rodney. Very weird to me. So he ends up going back to Denver for like not that long, gets traded to Boston, but Boston knows now. They're like, okay, well, he'll be out for the rest of the year because he has his foot surgery. And then they end up sending him to Orlando. And it's like, okay, so he was on Miami. They sent him to Denver. Denver sent him to Pitt, the Pistons, who sent him back to the Denver, who sent him to Boston, and then they sent him to Orlando. Orlando, he finally gets an opportunity, and he looks good. He actually looked good. Like, he had multiple stretches where he would do some crazy dribble moves, and you'd be like, oh, okay, he's kind of nice. And then he just doesn't get a ton of minutes again. Or he, whatever. Like, he has many injuries. I'm going to look at how many minutes per game he got last season with the with the Orlando Magic. He got 21 minutes per game. See, that's way more than he's ever gotten. His rookie year, he got 12 minutes per game for the Nuggets, and he averaged 6 points per game in those 12 minutes. That's pretty good. He averaged 9 points per game last year for Orlando in the 21 minutes. That's not bad either. And he shot only 26% from three. That's terrible. That's awful. 1.5 attempts per game. He shot 55% from the field, so you'll definitely take that. Played in 70 games, so he did stay pretty relatively healthy. Started 33 of them. I don't really know why they waived him. I don't know if it's because they have so many people on the roster already that play that position, and they were like, okay, it's not even worth it, or what it was, because he now is a free agent, and apparently the leading team to sign him is the Phoenix Suns. And that makes sense to me because I feel like Bol Bol is the type of guy that could go to a thin roster, but a contending roster, because it feels like teams that are looking to develop, just for whatever reason, don't want to develop Bol Bol. Now, I believe I've heard stuff about his attitude before and just his demeanor and like how he's kind of hard to get along with, and that could be part of it because I have heard that before, that he's not a great locker room guy. I know he looks really quiet on the court, but it sounds like he isn't the best in the locker room and is kind of hard to get along with. So that definitely could be part of it. Let's look at the Magic's roster right now, because obviously they have Mo Wagner, who they just re-signed. They have Wendell Carter Jr., so those are two centers right there, but Bol Bol played power forward for the most part. They have Paolo Banchero, so I guess that makes sense right there. Obviously, he's going to play over him. And then they have Admiral Schofield. I don't even know if Schofield is still on the roster technically, but Schofield only played 12 minutes per game, so he didn't play as much. Maybe they are trying to give him the reign, though. Yeah, he is still on the team. Oh, I guess it was a team option. I don't know if it got picked up or not. They had Gogo Batadze. They had Chuma Okeke. So they did have some other players that played his position. I guess maybe they want to give his minutes to Goga or to whoever. Paolo, which I don't blame them. That makes complete sense. But nonetheless, it is very weird that basically no one wants him, and he's still unsigned. he's still unsigned, which is so weird to me. I feel like there are many teams out there that could use a backup center. For an example, the Warriors just signed Dario Saric. Bol Bol, I still think, could be an option for them, and I don't think that would be a bad thing. I think he could fit well on the Warriors. The Phoenix Suns, they have. Oh man, who did they sign? Who did the Suns sign? It's a center. I want to say Drew Eubanks, but they didn't sign Drew Eubanks. Anyway, the Suns. Oh, obviously they have DeAndre Ayton, and then they've got some. They've got someone else that I can't think of at this exact moment. They definitely signed another center, I think, but doesn't really matter. Either way, they still could use another guy. Neither center is a power forward, big guy. I feel like he'd be all right there. Obviously, he gets Kevin Durant comparisons with the way he's really tall and long and skinny and can handle the ball. That's just Bol Bol, Chet Holmgren, and Victor Wembanyama. We're going to get those comparisons for their entire careers, basically. Those three kind of play very similarly, and it kind of goes up a ladder of like, okay, Bol Bol, then Chet, then Victor Wembanyama. That's the skill level. Obviously, Victor and Chet are light years ahead of Bol Bol, but either way, very similar skill sets nonetheless. So I think that, like I said, Warriors could be a good fit. The Suns, I'm not opposed to. I don't think that that's a bad fit necessarily. I could see the Lakers, obviously, because the Lakers centers right now are Anthony Davis and Jackson Hayes, and that is it. So they obviously need another center, and they still have two roster spots open. So one of those is definitely going to a big guy. And whether you call Bol Bol a power forward or center doesn't really matter. It's interchangeable, I would say. So I could see him being a fit there, but I think the Lakers are probably looking towards Christian Wood. And then, oh man, is there even any other teams? The Clippers don't need one. The Kings don't need one. The Spurs don't really need him, but I guess they could. They could. There's always talks of him going to match up with Victor Wembanyama. Always talks of him going to match up with Chet Holmgren and Poku. And then there's like a whole Twig three going around where it's a big three of the Twigs, but I don't see that happening. Technically, they could get on the court together because Poku, I think, plays small forward most of the time. And then you got Bol Bol at the power forward, Chet at the center, and they all kind of are interchangeable in that. That would be interesting, I guess. But I would say the three that I would watch out for are the Lakers, Warriors, and Suns. Those are the three I could think of off the top of my head where he would make sense. But I want to know your guys' thoughts in the comments down below. Why does nobody want Bol Bol? It's very weird to me. I don't get it. And yeah, that's it for the video, guys. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to leave a like, though, subscribe, and turn notification bells to all. I will see you guys in the next video. And yeah, stay tuned for the video tomorrow. Peace.